On this week's weekly video fishing forecast, we have the first reports of some schoolies from Robert Moses and the North Shore, all the details for the new Coastal Kayak Clash Fishing Tournament, and freshwater reports from our correspondents, all here at thefisherman.com. The Fishing News is brought to you by a band of anglers, Yozori, Humminbirdman Coda, Lamaglass, and Navionics. I'm back from sailing around the British Virgin Islands, and I was all excited to fish in the area, but what I didn't realize was how difficult it is to get a fishing permit down there. There's no online registration, so it must be done in person at a specific government office or by mail weeks in advance. The fines are high if you're caught, and I didn't want to be featured on a locked up abroad, so I figured I would just better off comply. What made things worse, however, was wherever we dropped anchor, tarpon would be huddled under our boat, teasing and laughing at me. I'll be back with the proper permit next time, so beware, tarpon. With the latest fishing news, we have senior editor, Fred Gallifaro.
Hey, Tim. Hey, people keep asking about the cod fishing, but it's kind of tough to give a cod report when none of the boats are really getting out. The Viking, they've been tied to the dock again all week. They do have a Nantucket wreck trip coming up, though. That departs Friday the 20th at 8 p.m. and returns Sunday at 1 a.m. To reserve a spot, go to 631-668-5700, or you can just go to vikingfleet.com. Then at a Captree, the Laura Lee Express is in the shipyard, so he hasn't been sailing. The Superhawk's been doing routine maintenance, although Captain Steve said he is planning on getting out this weekend. He's doing offshore wreck trips, leaving at 3 or 5 a.m. depending on where he's fishing, so be sure to give him a call to double check on that. 516-607-3004, you can reach Steve at. The Captain Lou Fleet, too, they're not doing any cod fishing, but they do have a canyon tilefish trip planned for March 21st. You want to reserve a spot on that trip. 516-623-5823. Now, we are starting to hear some striper reports. I spoke to two different guys at the Ward Melville show last weekend, and both told me they've been catching bass in the Robert Moses Surf on tins. I'm hearing from a lot of people that there's a lot of birds working along the beach, most people assuming the herring, but it sounds like there's bass in there also. So if you're looking for something to do, the weather's been great, might be worth a shot. I also heard of some small bass up in Mount Sinai Harbor from Jim at Miller Place Bait and Tackle. They're open again for the season. They were closed for a couple of months, so you could check that out too. You know, I have to guess that Little Neck Bay is probably worth checking out. I don't see why there wouldn't be fish there. We've had real good fishing in March in Little Neck Bay in the past. It's been quite a few years, but it has happened. So that might be worth checking out. Shows, I did hear and I did confirm it with the show's promoter, Dave, that the Patchogue Fishing Flea Market is canceled, and that's due to St. Joseph's College being closed through the end of the month. So take that off the calendar. Saltwater Expo, which starts this Friday.
Sorry to cut you off, Fred, but we have this late breaking news. The Saltwater Fishing Expo in Edison, New Jersey has been canceled due to concerns over the coronavirus. The silver lining is, if you are planning to renew your subscription this weekend at the show, the Fisherman has a special promotion for you. Renew online with promo code Edison and get $3 off a one-year subscription and get this 8-inch Savage Sand Eel mailed to you. Supplies are limited, and this offer ends Sunday the 15th at midnight. Back to Fred, already in progress.
Another reminder, and I'll remind you every week until the deadline, State Park Beach permits, the Beach Vehicle Permit, and the Sport Fishing Permit. You have until March 31st. If you don't get it by then, you're going to be waiting till after Labor Day to pick one up. Tim, back to you.
There's a new fishing contest for all you kayakers out there. With all the details, here's Toby Lipinski, the New England editor.
We have some big news here at the Fisherman Magazine as we are launching our first ever kayak-only fishing tournament in 2020. Now, it was first announced in the March print issue of The Fisherman, and we now have an article posted online at thefisherman.com, which also includes a video unveiling the grand prize kayak. Now, similar to our Dream Boat Fishing Challenge, the Coastal Kayak Clash is a season-long, multi-species fishing tournament open to subscribers of the Fisherman magazine. Now, fishing is going to begin on May 1st, and it concludes on November 30th, and the list of eligible species is lengthy, covering fish that you're going to find all across the Northeast and Mid-Atlantic coasts, including weakfish, porgy, fluke, sea robin, bluefish, black sea bass, blackfish, and we're calling a combo hardtail category, which includes both false albacore as well as bonita. Now, entries are going to be based on length, so there's no need or requirement to harvest a fish to compete in a tournament. But of course, participants of the Coastal Kayak Clash may harvest any entry, obviously so long as it meets local season and bag limits. The top three fish in each species category will be assigned points, and at the conclusion of the tournament, the angler who has the highest point total will be crowned the champion and take home the grand prize kayak, a brand new Old Town Sportsman Series Autopilot 136, complete with a Minn Kota trolling motor, just like you see here. Now, I fished on this boat a couple of weeks ago while I was down in Florida, and it was an absolute dream to use. Between the stability when standing up to cast and fight fish, as well as the ease of powering along thanks to the 45-pound thrust Minn Kota trolling motor. Then when I got onto some fish, all I had to do was hit a button and lock in the GPS-enabled spot lock feature, and the kayak held me in place without any additional effort on my part. Then when I was ready to move along, hit a button and continued right down along the shoreline and continued fishing. Now, there is no additional entry fee required to participate in the Coastal Kayak Clash, as the entry is automatically including with your existing Fisherman magazine subscription. So for more information on the Coastal Kayak Clash, check out the post right now at thefisherman.com and be sure to watch the related video.
Paul McCain from River Bay Outfitters has this freshwater report.
Hello, Tim. It's been incredible weather. Right now it is Wednesday, and right now it's gonna be close to 60 degrees today. It's just incredible. Guys have been fishing. The Kennequot Park has been doing well. Just in general, everybody's been doing well. They're trying to get it acclimated. And I just talked to Heidi over at the DEC. They're doing their stocking starting next week. So all the lakes and ponds, some have already been stocked. There are a lot of fish around. The Carls River's got a good stocking. Belmont Lake. And there's a lot of things coming up. And this is just the beginning of the season. And I'm excited about it. Now, don't forget, save the date. March 28th, we're still on, and it's bigger than better than ever. So make sure you get to the Fly Fishing Expo of Long Island in Radisson Hotel. Go to riverbayoutfitters.com, look at the expo page, see all the presentations, see all the demonstrations, all the vendors. It's going to be a phenomenal show. So hopefully everybody will be safe this week, and tight lines, everybody, and see you next week.
Spring will be here soon, and if you're in the market for a quality fishing boat that's affordable, check out a C-Pro powered by Suzuki. For less than $400 a month, get you into all the action. Visit Kale's Family Boating Center for a test ride today. For another freshwater report, we have Chris Ludwig.
Thanks, Tim. What's going on, guys? So this last week and a half, I continued on looking for those trout and did fairly well. I was throwing a combination of yellow trout magnets and green and black. But I ended up taking the stock worm off and throwing something on called a Berkeley Powerbait Mice Tail. And what that is, it's like an inch or two long worm with attached to what would look like a salmon egg. So, yes, a mouse tail. Anyway, those baits, when we would throw them in and fish them exactly like a trout magnet, these trouts would key in on them, and they would grab by the tip of the tail, and you would watch them hold onto it for about 3 or 4 seconds, which is a big deal, because then they would suck it in, you'd be able to set the hook. So that realistic taste certainly helps out. Also, on my way home, I couldn't resist myself. I stopped by one of my ponds, and I was throwing those gambler paddle tails again and ended up hooking into a nice stud pickerel. My buddy Joey from Fishing Long Island came by, and he took a picture just in time, so it worked out. Weather's looking good. Also, I forgot to mention this. We started seeing bunker in the back bays near East Rockaway and Hewlett, all that. It was full-size adult bunker in the lights by one of my spots, so things are looking really good. You can only hope that the striped bass will come around soon. I know the season doesn't start till April 15th, but it looks like some substantial fish may show up. Anyway, guys, good fishing. Hope you enjoy yourselves. Take care.
Regular contributor Kirk Fay was down in Costa Rica on a fishing vacation with his wife, Gina. Kirk, tell me about your trip.
Hey, just like Tim had mentioned, me and my wife, Gina, went to Los Sueños in Costa Rica. There's a Marriott inside the complex that we stayed. It was amazing. The scenery, the pools, there's condos. If you don't want to do the hotel thing, there's plenty of condos you could rent. Everything's within walking distance from the hotel to the marina to all the restaurants, sushi restaurants, Italian restaurants, steakhouse, if that's what you want to do. There's so much to do there, but we really were there to go fishing. The only time we actually left the premise was to go ziplining, which, trust me, that to me is a must-do. That was awesome. But as far as fishing goes, we fished 3 days on the Epic. The captain's name is Mike, and we caught everything. We caught sailfish, striped marlin, blue marlin, dorado, tuna, grouper, snapper. You name it. And the best is at every single restaurant, if you bring back fish for them, they'll cook it for you. If you're looking for somewhere to go, Los Sueños in Costa Rica has to be on your bucket list. Until then, I'll talk to you later.
If you want to get an idea how the spring migration of striped bass is going, I encourage you to check out our New Jersey Weekly Video Fishing Forecast with Jim Hutchinson. Just click on the card above or check out this video's description for the link. Here are some upcoming fishing events. The Fisherman is now on Amazon Fire TV, Roku, Apple TV, and Android TV. So now you can watch this broadcast and our other video content on the big screen. Just search for The Fisherman TV on any of those devices. Remember, like our video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and tap on the bell to be notified instantly when we post a new video on YouTube. And of course, be a subscriber to The Fisherman Magazine to be part of the Dream Boat and Kayak Clash Contest. Check out this video's description on YouTube for all the related links and more information. And please support our correspondents by visiting their website and social media pages. See you next week, right here at thefisherman.com.